Hey people, I've been playing with 3D printed Lithophanes and making these awesome photos come to life. Check it out! So the concept of Lithophanes has been around for hundreds of years. They were originally made of thin porcelain and would involve etching or moulding the artwork onto the substrate and shining a light source behind to reveal the artwork. Now, thin areas, of course, let more light through, and thicker areas less, so with some skill, some quite detailed images could be represented. Now, only in recent years, we've seen them 3D printed, and people have figured out loads of cool ways of making them. Some of you who may have been looking at my Instagram recently have noticed that I've been making quite a few of them, and you can too, directly in Cura or your favourite 3D modelling package. But I've been using this free online tool by Mark Durbin. It's available at 3dp.rocks/lithophane, and I'll post a direct link to that in the video description below. Now, this tool allows you to upload an image and it will directly process this into an STL model file, which of course you can download and print on your 3D printer. Now, there are some basic controls for modifying the STL, different thicknesses and different shapes. For example, you've got a flat, a pretty standard flat, curves, both concaved and convex, a solid cylinder, pillow-shaped, dome-shaped, and even heart-shaped. Printing them needs to be done vertically because the bottom layer squashing can really distort and lessen the effect. So once you've got your image turned into a model, you may need to rotate it. Now, I've done a few tests of on different thicknesses, and I found for normal ABS and PLA, 3mm is about optimal. Any less, you lose a bit of definition, because you do need some meat on there to see the detail. Any more, and of course the light doesn't get through the thicker parts. Seems only right I do one of these in wood as well, right? Well, okay, wood full filament, a 3D printer filament which is partly made of wood. I've used this stuff a fair bit over the years, and I love it. It's light, it smells woody, and you can give it a bit of fake grain by altering the temperature that it's printing at. Doesn't taste like wood though. If you want to go really far, however, and maybe increase the thickness a lot, you can produce some amazing effects like this. This is 50mm, and Ben Malouf has been using this effect to make some amazing optical illusions, so definitely worth checking out his stuff. I'll pop a link in there below as well. Now, I've done a few of these recently and I really like them. Look at the profile effect there, and of course you turn it around and whee! Although I'm sure somebody has done it already, I've not seen anybody do much with stop motion Lithophanes yet. Probably because there isn't any logical reason, but hey, we don't need logic. This is a Kirk kind of channel, not a Spock kind of channel. And sometimes you just want to do stuff because you can. And partly to celebrate the new Star Trek spin-off, Picard, and partially because I needed something short to test, I decided to use the classic Picard facepalm meme. First, I used this nifty online tool, EasyGIF, to break the meme into separate images. There were about 39 in total, but I only needed 27 of them to fully convey what was going on. I then manually imported and made STLs for each of the images, and then of course I 3D printed them.
Beauty!
3D printed memes, people! With all the Picards printed, I needed some kind of jig so they could all be placed in the same place relative to the camera, and so I could run a little stop motion magic. Now, I was going to 3D print something complicated and well designed, but hey, a bit of scrap wood will do fine just for testing. Camera mounted on one end with an elastic band. I'm using a Logitech webcam here, as it's a great little camera for being able to adjust settings. It's the C920, I believe. There we go, pop the light the other end, and the frame goes in the middle. Little bit of experimentation was needed just to get the thing just right. Took a while to play with the settings on the camera as well, just to get things looking good. Contrast needed to go up a bit higher so we can make out the detail. Oh, and mustn't forget the basics. Make sure everything's in focus. I put a mark on the wood where the base sits so I can make sure each frame is in the same place each time I take a photo. And just to make extra sure, I glued a little bit of wood onto the board so the frame can just quickly push up against it. I wasn't too worried about it being slightly too left or right because the frame can be fixed again in the software later, but the distance from the camera, that's a little trickier. Now, the fun job. Let's take a photo of each of the 27 frames. While I'm doing this, please consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell, and you will be informed of when I do my next video. With the photos done, I imported them into Adobe Premiere. This is remarkably easy to do. Just make sure the images have some kind of sensible number order as the file name. In Premiere, go to Import, select the first image you want to use, and tick the Image Sequence checkbox. This will import all those images as a sequence, and then you can use it just like any video clip in Premiere. And to complete the circle, I rendered it as an animated GIF. And again, this is really easy to do in the latest versions of Premiere. Just select the animated GIF option as your export format. And there we go. Happy Picard Day, everybody. So what's next? Well, I'm going to do some more 3D printed videos, and I'd love to know from you lot, what should I do next? Nyan Cat maybe? Or maybe that awesome cat video that we saw last week? There's bound to be one, yeah? Or that kid that's pretending he's got a lightsaber and he's going all nuts and... Let me know in the comments below, and as usual, smash that like button if you like what you saw, and consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell if you want to see more videos like this. Oh, and I've uploaded this lovely Picard Lithophane stop motion video. Gotta find a shorter way of saying that. I've uploaded it onto Giphy, so if you want to use it, feel free. Thanks all.